It's incredible. So the woman says she's a prostitute. The priest says, oh, thank God. I thought you said you were a Protestant. Great to see you. I'll never tell you who told me that joke. I promise. Good to see you again. Okay, next time.
Ah, so sorry. Hurry!
Hi. There you are.
Thank you. What'd I miss?
Well, dinner for one. Pleasure of my company. Where were you?
Not the only one who works weekends.
Send a bottle of champagne over to the Donner table. Make sure it's vintage.
How'd you know Donner?
I baptized his son a few years ago.
That's fortuitous.
Yes, isn't it? I did, after all, make up the schedule.
You are some piece of work.
Learn from the best. So how much more money do we need for the children's hospital?
3.5.
What's this?
I missed you at Vespers.
Hama, what are you doing lurking out here? It's freezing.
Mass this morning, too.
I've been a little busy lately.
Brendan covered it for you.
I'll make it up to him. My way.
This is Jeffrey Altman from Harrington and Rosenberg.
Ah, nice to meet you.
Pleasure. Thought I knew everyone over there.
Jeff's a criminal lawyer.
Really?
One of our priests was arrested last night. Tom Andrews from St. Dominic's.
Well, what happened?
He's being charged with murder.
The victim's name is Eric Halloran. He worked at a teen shelter where Father Andrews counseled. Rented a room from a woman who ran the place, a Lucy Gallagher. Says she fell asleep in the tub. Woke and saw Andrews kneeling over Halloran's body, covered in blood. His head was bashed in.
What does Father Andrews say?
He says he needs a priest.
To confess?
He, specifically asked for you.
Me? Did he say why?
The press will have a field day with this.
We need to be clear on our position.
Which is?
We pray for the vindication of Father Andrews, and we have faith that the justice system will reveal the truth.
So if he's found guilty, it won't appear that our faith was misguided.
Precisely. I'll have the public relations office put together a statement.
Thank you. Daniel. You came. You don't remember me, do you?
From where?
Seminary. We had Merton together. Your thesis was inspirational.
Will you excuse us, Mr. Altman?
If I go, your conversation isn't privileged.
Please.
Look, be careful what you say. You too.
You wouldn't understand.
I was told you needed a priest. Would you like to make a confession?
To murder?
Yes.
I didn't kill anybody.
Then why do you need a priest?
Because the police are asking questions I can't answer.
Like?
What I was doing at the crime scene.
And what were you doing there?
I can't tell you either.
Why not?
Because I'm bound by the seal of confession.
Did someone confess the crime to you?
No, something else.
Do you know who the killer is?
No, I don't. Maybe.
And how are you bound?
I wouldn't have gone to Eric's otherwise.
Thomas, you need to tell the police.
I can't. You should know that.
Halloran's killer is still out there. You need to help find him, if you're telling the truth.
If? I didn't do this. Are you gonna help me or not?
I'll see what I can do.
Is there, anything else you need?
My prayer book, it's at the rectory. Daniel, wait. Will you pray for me?
Seal of confession. Ladies and gentlemen, the jury, my client is innocent and might know who did it, but he won't say. How does that sound with blood on his pen?
Not won't.
Can't.
It sounds like bullshit.
He took a vow. If he breaks it, it's a mortal sin. He's got to be willing to risk prison, torture, even death to defend it.
Would you?
Well, I'm not the one on trial.
You all are.
Today, with a priest arrested in last night's slaying of Eric Halloran, 19. Father Thomas Andrews is the pastor at downtown St. Dominic's Church. The police say he was with the victim at the time of his death. Thus far, church officials have had no comment. The trial date will be determined later this week.
You believe him?
I don't really know what to believe. He seems stable. He's never been in trouble before. And there's no motive.
But he won't offer an alibi. That's pretty convenient.
Boom. I mean, he could spend the rest of his life in jail.
You sure you can't get Father Andrews to talk?
I'm not so sure I'm supposed to.
We all do things we're not supposed to.
Not quite what I expected.
Why does Father Andrews think he's bound? Did you not say the confessor never spoke of the murder?
Oh, whoever it was said something that brought Father Andrews to the crime scene. He wouldn't have been there otherwise.
He doesn't have to tell us what was said, just who said it.
He won't.
Pious little twit.
Does he understand the implications to us?
I don't think he's too concerned about that, at least not enough to change his mind.
Well, then change it for him.
What about this? Is there anything we can do?
I believe it's vital that we get our side of the story out there, even if Father Andrews won't help himself.
How do we do that?
We put him on TV. Let him state his case. People can make up their own minds, and it won't look like we're hiding him.
Do it.
I'll set up an interview. Father Hummel should take over speaking with Father Andrews.
Why not you?
I'm scheduled to be in New York tomorrow to meet with the banks. We're closing the deal in the family center, and...
We need you here.
Hummel can deal with New York.
I really don't feel Hummel will be quite as effective as
your effectiveness is precisely why I want you supervising this. Why I'll hold you responsible for its outcome. Is that clear?
Perfectly, Your Eminence. Father Daniel Clements. I'm looking for Madeline Finney. Thank you. I have to say, you look fantastic.
Thanks.
So, how long have you been a Finney?
Oh, 6 years. I got rid of the husband, but kept the name for work, you know?
I'm sorry.
No, I'm not. He was a jerk. So what are you doing here, anyway? I mean, not here, but in the city.
Well, I live here.
Since when?
Oh, it's been a few years now.
I've been doing the news here for 11 months now.
I know. I have been meaning to call. I just...
What do you want, Danny?
I thought we could help each other.
How?
It's this priest, Father Andrews. I'd like you to interview him.
And how does that help you?
Well, he says he's innocent. We'd like the world to know that.
Do you think he's innocent?
You know, I've never been to a newsroom before. This is very exciting.
But you want me to put him on anyway?
I have some questions we'd like you to ask him.
Get a publicist.
That's not how I meant it.
No? How did you mean it?
Listen, this is the biggest news story in town. I'd like you to handle it exclusively. Just think about it. Really is great to see you.
Ask him anything that makes me advise him not to answer. One question about his alibi, it's over. You understand?
You are standing in the light. Got it.
What happened?
I fell. Did you get my brief?
This is important. You have to focus.
So is that, Daniel.
I spoke to the Cardinal. He says you can reveal the confessor without revealing the contents of the confession. There'll be no consequences.
Of course there will. Just not from him. How can you not understand?
Hi. I'm Madeline Finney. We all set? Can I put some? Okay. Father Andrews, could you tell us what happened when you arrived at Lucy Gallagher's house on the night of January the 29th?
I knocked. The door was ajar, so I went in. I knew something was wrong right away. There was blood everywhere. Then I found the body.
And what did you do then?
I knelt down and administered last rites.
And then you left?
Yes.
And did you call the police?
No.
Did you tell anybody?
No.
Why not? How well did you know Eric Halloran?
He worked at the Angel Shelter. I help out by giving religious instruction there.
Did you know he would be at Lucy Gallagher's house that night?
Yes, he lived there.
So you went to see him?
Yes.
And were you aware that he used to be a prostitute?
Okay, that's it. We're done.
I knew about Eric, but that was in his past. He was doing good work at the shelter. He tried to keep the kids from making the same mistakes he had made.
So why did you go to see him?
I can't answer that.
Was it because someone told you something during confession?
Yes.
something that prompted you to go to Halloran's home.
I'm sorry, I can't discuss that.
Even though it means hindering a murder investigation.
You have to understand, that person wasn't confessing to me. He was confessing to God through me. That's what people do when they come to confessions. They talk to God in confidence. And if they thought that that wasn't true, even in a case like this, then they might stop going. I won't be responsible for people thinking they can't talk to him about anything.
Father Andrews, did you kill Eric Halloran?
No.
Maddie, I'd like to have a word with you. Excuse me. How did you find out Halloran was a prostitute?
I'm a reporter, Daniel. That's what we do.
You made it look like Andrews was having a relationship with him.
Well, maybe he was. Maybe he molested him. Maybe he killed him in order to cover it up. We don't know, Daniel.
I'm not sure Andrews did this.
Neither am I. But the police think they have their guy. So if there's even the slightest chance that Andrews is innocent, maybe the church should be trying to help him rather than letting you hang him out to dry. Thanks for setting it up. I owe you lunch.
Hello. Henry. No, 90 basis points. That's it. That's our final offer. Trust me, they'll accept it. Where am I? I'm at St. Dominic's. Doing penance. I'm scheduled to leave for New York in a couple days. I'll deal with that when I get back. Well, I asked Hummel to take care of it. So I gotta go. Okay?
Yes?
Hi, I'm Father Daniel Clemens. Father Andrews wanted me to pick up his breed for him.
Well, I suppose you better come in.
Thank you.
Police have been all over the place. Took me hours to clean up. Father's okay, though?
As well as can be expected.
Huh. When will he be back? Church has been locked since he left. No mass said, confession either.
I don't know, we'll probably have to bring in another pastor.
Fat chance of that. Bills need paying. He didn't do what they say, you know. A couple of the fathers been through here. Well, you might call them kind of funny, but Father Andrews?
Thank you, Mrs. Donnelly. Dear Thomas, I can't tell you what your presence at our meetings is to the group. Thank you for the courage you've shown in coming here. Warmest regards, James.
You read my mail?
Are you gay?
What business is that of yours?
I know what equality is.
I counsel there. James is a friend.
It's been banned by the church. You could be removed from your parish.
It's pretty low on my list of problems right now.
Who else knows about this?
I haven't hidden my involvement.
Well, you should have. Do you understand how this looks? Halloran is a prostitute. You've admitted you know him well. You go to his house. You counsel at equality. This gives you a motive.
Because I might be homosexual.
No, because you could be a pedophile. Were you having sex with Eric Halloran?
When was the last time you prayed, Daniel? I mean, really prayed.
You've got a lot of nerve.
God understands your doubts. He knows your weaknesses. But if you search with your heart, you will find him waiting. He wants you back, Daniel.
Do you want to go to jail, Thomas?
No.
Then tell me who the confessor was. Then you can go free. You can go back to practicing God's work. You can have your life back. You're gonna have to do a lot more than pray for yourself.
I'm praying for you, Daniel.
Can we begin? In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. We've just begun. Can you shut the door behind you, please? The first reading is from the reading of Luke, chapter 6, 27. Jesus said, love your enemies.
Get out of your way, Padre.
Do good to them.
I'm a friend of Father Andrews.
Bless them that curse you.
He told me he used to work with your group.
Spitefully use you.
Well, if that were true, it would be quite indiscreet.
Look, I really don't care what goes on here. I'm just here to find a few things out. That's all.
What goes on here, Father, is a celebration of our faith in Christ. If you really were Tom's friend, you would care very much.
Give to every man that asks us the and of him that taketh away thy
you might want to go.
Ask them not again.
Excuse me.
He's about to start the Mass.
For if ye love them which love you, what thank ye have? For sinners also love those that love them.
Father Clemens! Yes, I'm sorry. That was rude in there. But the church has spies everywhere.
How did you know who I am?
Oh, we know everyone at the Archdiocese, friend or foe.
Which am I?
You tell me.
Look, I think Father Andrews is protecting someone from something that was said in confession. Could be a member of your group.
Yeah, it could be. But Tom followed the rules. He didn't say Mass or hear confession here. Yeah, maybe St. Dominic's, but that could have been anyone.
Did you know Eric well?
Oh, yeah. Everyone around here knew Eric.
Is he a member?
What? Of equality? Please. If Tom has a fault to set, he sees the good in everyone. Nah, Eric was a lost cause.
Father Andrews seemed to think he was doing okay.
No, he was a punk and a liar. He'd do anything to anyone at any time.
For instance?
Well, he was a whore. Yeah. And he loved married guys, especially the ones with money. Shake his little ass, reel them in, then he'd blackmail them once he'd had his fun. He was an evil little shit. Sorry, forgive my saying.
Is it, possible that, he and Andrews may have been having a relationship?
What, a sexual one? No, absolutely not. Look, I told that reporter, Tom Strait, and as far as I know, he's celibate.
Well, what reporter?
That woman from Channel 5.
Thank you.
What are you doing here?
We had a deal.
No, we didn't. You told me the way you wanted things to be and expected me to play by your rules.
Because I didn't think I could trust you.
You were one to talk.
What does that mean? What are you talking about?
You left me, Danny, for God, supposedly. And everybody said, isn't that great? Aren't you proud? Well, it wasn't great, and I wasn't proud. I was hurt and lonely. But I couldn't complain because you were the wonderful one. You were the one with the calling.
I thought you understood it was something I had to do.
I know. And I didn't blame you for it then, but it took me a long time to get over it. And then you just show up at my office like, hey, Maddie, like none of it ever happened. And you ask me for my help, but for what? To protect the church and your job? I thought you'd be out healing lepers or feeding the hungry or something, but not this. What happened to you?
I grew up, just like everybody else.
Exactly. Work.
What is it?
Father Andrews is dead.
So we're accepting that Father Andrews committed suicide then, is that it? How'd you get a hold of that? He's only been dead 3 hours?
Because he's general counsel, that's his job. I'll schedule the press conference for 8. Just read the statement. You can refer questions to the public relations office.
I just don't think it's, this is right.
Based on what? Do you know something we don't? Have you added telepathy to your list of accomplishments?
Your Eminence, with all due respect, he refuses to break the seal of confession and then decides to hang himself in a prison shower, risking being barred from heaven. I find that hard to believe.
This case is closed.
We'll issue the statement to put this matter behind us in the best interest of the church and yourself. Is there anything else?
This is a statement from His Eminence, Cardinal Francis Ledesma. It is with deep regret that we announce the death of Father Thomas Andrews while in custody. Father Andrews maintained his innocence throughout this ordeal. The Archdiocese draws no conclusion from the manner of his death. We pray for his soul and ask the community to do likewise.
Come on, Father.
Did anyone know?
At this time, there'll be no further questions.
The Archdiocese draws no conclusion. You know he didn't kill himself.
I've done what I was required to do. It's over, Maddie.
How proud should I be now?
Morning, Bishop Serrano.
Morning, Danny. I heard about your meeting last night.
Yeah, it was pretty late. I'm sorry you weren't there.
I am too.
Grace, I have a request. I'd like to assume Father Andrew's duties at St. Dominic's, at least until a replacement pastor can be found.
Parish work isn't exactly your strong suit. And down there, you'd be a bit out of place, don't you think?
I promised Father Andrews I'd look after things for him. I feel it's the least I can do.
Finding a new pastor could take months. Don't you have other matters to attend to? Business matters?
I feel I can manage both. I did give him my word. Thank you.
Daniel, you should be more careful about saying no to the Cardinal.
Oh, I've cleaned his room and packed his things. I'd have put them in the basement, but someone's coming for them later on.
You don't have a spare room?
Oh, roof leaks. It's not fit. There's confessions this evening between 6 and 7. I'll look in on you tomorrow.
Marion. Thomas's mother.
Come in. I'm sorry about the mess. I haven't had a chance to straighten up yet.
Thomas loved it like this. Made him feel closer to his people. He wouldn't let me come down after he was arrested. I guess he was ashamed. Things they said on television. It was no better at home, believe me. He wrote to me, though. About you.
About me? What did he say?
He said you were a good man. That you were looking out for him, and that he was praying for you.
Did he ever say why?
Thomas would never do anything like that. He could have been anything, you know. Doctor, lawyer. He was so smart. But his whole life was the church. And his faith. And the people here. How can they say this about him? That he killed himself. Or that boy. His whole life. Now, I can't have his funeral in a church. I'll bury him in consecrated ground. How can they do this to us?
Thank you.
name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Blessed be Father, for I've sinned. It's been, I don't know, like a year since my last confession.
A year?
Well, I move around a lot.
I don't hear confession in those places.
Look, the shelter says we gotta go to confession if we want to stay there. So here I am, all right?
The shelter says you've gotta go to confession? Who's making you go to confession?
Miss Gallagher. She runs the place. You gonna give me confession or not?
You don't have to confess if you don't want to. Hello? Actually left. That's great.
Bless me, Father, for I have sinned. I stole a banana and ate the skin.
Hello, Henry. Good to see you.
What the hell have you got yourself into, Danny boy?
Some kind of stew, I think.
Just like Mama used to make.
I haven't had a chance to stock the wine rack yet.
Daniel, it's a church. If you don't mind my asking, what exactly are you doing here?
I'm filling in for Father Andrews. I promised him I would.
He's not here to know. And we've got real work back at the shop.
Well, this is real work. Oh, bingo.
For Father Andrews, sure. But you've got skills, and they can be put to better use than this. Let them close the place for a while. Come back where you belong. You can keep an eye on things from there.
I don't think I can do that right now.
Tell me something. You're not taking matters into your own hands here, are you?
Look, I don't believe Andrews was guilty, and I know he didn't commit suicide. When I could help him, I didn't. I don't know how to deal with that just yet. So, until I do, I'm gonna stay here, keep my promise. If I happen to stumble across something that clears his name, all the better, right?
Fair enough. All I've accomplished and has come to this.
Are there worse things in life than cheap altar wine?
True. But how many? Come by the house tomorrow. Have a real meal. Mary's been asking for you.
Hey, now, do you want me to walk you to your car? Are you going to feel safe out there in this neighborhood?
I grew up in worse neighborhoods than this, Sonny. They should be worried about me.
That's what I thought.
But you should watch your back. If Father Andrews didn't kill Halloran, somebody else did.
Today's gospel, we heard the words of Jesus. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for his sheep. I'm not much of a shepherd. To be honest, I haven't really tried. But Father Andrews was. He was a good man. Who sacrificed his life rather than violate the principles he believed in. Now, I know a lot of you have heard or read stories about his case. One thing I know for sure in my heart of hearts, Tom Andrews did not kill Eric Halloran. He also didn't kill himself. If I do nothing else with the time God has given me with you, I'm going to find out who did. Let us pray. We believe in one God, Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God. Miss Gallagher here.
Through there.
Thank you.
Well, I've hurried up, you two.
Miss Gallagher.
Mrs.
Oh, sorry.
You're the new pastor.
That's right. I'm Father Daniel Clemens. I'm filling in at St. Dominic's. If you have a moment, I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Let's go.
Did you know Father Andrews well?
Of course. He worked with the kids. He heard confessions.
And Eric Halloran, you were roommates, right?
He was my boarder.
Did you know he was a prostitute?
Are you accusing me of something?
No. I'm just trying to figure out what happened to him and Father Andrews.
I told the police everything I know.
Okay. Have a nice day, then. Oh, you know, there was one other thing. One of the kids came by confession the other night and said that you were forcing them to go.
They wouldn't go otherwise.
I understand, but perhaps there's a way maybe I could help to persuade them rather than you having to do that.
You have kids of your own, Father?
No, of course not.
Then where do you get off telling me how to raise mine?
No, I wasn't. I was just trying to...
I've been doing this for 20 years. While you have been up at St. James having your lunches and playing golf in the afternoon. And then you come down here in your fancy car and your gold watch, think you can straighten things out and what, head back uptown in time for a martini with the boys? This is what I do. I know how to handle these kids, and I would appreciate it if you would keep your opinions to yourself. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have work to do.
I'm sorry, Henry. I haven't had a chance to look at that yet. I'm a little busy. Can I call you back? Hello?
doing back there?
I'm just trying to get some sleep.
Why aren't you at the shelter? I mean, you don't belong here.
We just came from the shelter.
Why'd you leave?
We just needed a place to crash, all right?
Well, I'm gonna go call Mrs. Gallagher.
No, don't. We're sorry. We'll just go.
Yeah, tell Miss Gallagher to kiss my ass.
Shut up, Cameron.
What's so wrong with Mrs. Gallagher?
She spies on us. She knows everything we do before we do it. And then she punishes us. Bad.
It doesn't matter. Look, she won't even let us back in after 10. Can we just stay tonight?
I don't know. Okay, yeah. You stay down here. You can stay up in the living room, all right? Call Mrs. Gallagher in the morning. Sleep in here. What did he mean?
When he said Mrs. Gallagher punishes you.
Mrs. Donnelly. Mrs. Donnelly! Where are the kids?
Pardon?
Cameron and Monica. Have you seen them?
There are no kids here, Father. Your breakfast's on the table, though.
Daniel, can we meet?
The federal investigation into civil corruption continues today. Mayor Martin announced that if found guilty of any wrongdoing, he will resign. I'm Madeline Finney for WPPI. Got it?
Hey.
Hey.
What's the latest scandal?
Judicial corruption, waste in our schools, and elderly drivers. What's on your mind?
You owe me lunch.
We even?
Well, not yet. I owe you an apology.
What for?
For knowing you were in town, not coming to see you sooner. For using you to do the interview with Father Andrews instead of just asking for your help. And to say that, you were right. He does deserve more than to just be written off by the church.
I heard you took over for him at St. Dominic's.
Wow, news travels fast.
And you're a reporter.
I'm a little out of my element. I stopped by the shelter where he used to counsel. I tried to talk to the lady who works there, Mrs. Gallagher.
What did she say about Halloran?
Not much. To be honest with you, she couldn't get me out of there fast enough. Kids are scared to death of her.
Isn't she the one who claims she saw Andrews over the body?
Thank you.
Talk about suspicious. Woman goes to church for no reason at all.
Coming or not? Gallagher! Oh, did you, wish to make a confession?
No.
Did you lose something, then?
Ah, yes. Cameron and Monica, I hear they spent the night with you.
I slept on the rectory floor, not with me.
And what'd they tell you?
Not much, just that they were frightened. Particularly of you.
They're kids. They lie. You really think they're better off on your floor than in my shelter?
I'm starting to wonder. What is that in your hand?
It's mine. I dropped it during confession.
You weren't in confession.
Last week, Father Andrews.
Daniel.
You're taping their confessions?
Look, I don't have to answer to the likes of you. Excuse me.
Tape.
This isn't over. Not by a long shot.
You believe that? You can't listen to this. These are her kids' confessions.
You can't listen to them. I'm Miss Philly.
You're still a Catholic, aren't you? I'm gonna go lock up. Does.
Do you want to grab a bite of
tea? I can't. I'll just take you home. The show. Or did you just come by for some more of my fine home cooking?
Business, Dan. There's been a complaint. I wanted to tell you myself.
Oh, yes. Father, you know Mrs. Gallagher?
Yes.
Yes. Mrs. Gallagher says you've been harassing her.
Stopped by the shelter to introduce myself.
He let two of my kids sleep over.
On the floor. They seemed terrified. I was worried about them, so I followed her.
There, you see? And with a woman, some news reporter, Maddie something.
Is this true, Daniel?
Yes.
I'm very, very sorry. Thank you for bringing this to our attention, Mrs. Gallagher.
Thank you, Mrs. Gallagher.
Are you completely out of your mind?
That woman has been taping confessions. Maddie found a recorder.
She was what?
Did you listen to it?
No, no.
That is not our concern. What is our concern is your apparent inability to follow my simplest instructions. Eric Halloran's case is closed. Father Andrew's suicide is settled.
I'm sorry, I can't accept that.
Have you ever been to Equality, Daniel?
Yes.
But you're aware of our position on that.
Yes, I'm aware. What is this? What's going on?
And this woman, the reporter, what is the nature of your relationship?
She's an old friend. What's happening here? What's this?
It's a plane ticket. First class to New York. You have a meeting with our bankers tomorrow morning.
You don't understand. I can't go. Who will look after St. Dominic's?
St. Dominic's will be closed, effective immediately. There's no one else we can send. I'm sorry, Daniel.
Carl will take you to the airport. We'll send someone to St. Dominic's for your things.
Sorry, Your Eminence, I can't.
Daniel, I've tolerated your behavior for a long time because your talent for fundraising offsets your shortcomings as a priest. But understand this. I'm not asking you. I'm telling you. And your car is waiting.
You can't save St. Dominic's, Danny. So save yourself. Just get on the plane.
No.
So be it. As of this moment, you are removed of your faculties. You will neither say mass nor hear confessions. And it will be determined in due course whether or not you are still suited for the priesthood.
Yes, Your Eminence. I'll see to it. But Father Clemens.
A moment.
The Cadillac?
You don't waste any time, do you?
And your credit cards. Just the business ones, of course. Are we forgetting something?
Feel free to wear it.
You need to find new living arrangements, of course. Say by the end of the week.
I'll be gone by the morning.
Is she here?
Hey,
Monica!
She's not here. What's going on?
Where is she? Where is she?
Cameron, take it easy. I don't know. When was the last time you saw her?
The shelter. She was crying. She left with Gallagher. They haven't come back.
Oh. All right. Cameron, I'm sure she's okay. I'll get my stuff. I'll help you go look for her, all right?
She's not okay. She wouldn't just leave. Gallagher's got her.
Gallagher's got her? Why?
She thinks we ratted on
Cameron!
Her.
Cameron!
Cameron! Ratted her out for what? Cameron!
Hey.
Why don't we just go to the police?
If we go to the police and I'm wrong, she'll have me arrested. She's already gotten me fired. Let's just go to her place. You talk to her, keep her busy. I'll look around for Monica. She'll never know I'm there.
You hope.
I'll wait here until you get around to the front, okay?
basement and I'll check upstairs.
Okay. God, whose property it is, ever to have mercy and despair, we beseech thee on behalf of the soul of thy servant, Arthur Miles, look upon her with pity and let her be conducted to the holy angels to paradise, her true country. Grant that she who believed in thee and hoped in thee may not be left to suffer the pains of the purgatory of hell, may be admitted to eternal joys. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, be with thee.
Was it an overdose?
Looks like it. She had tracks up and down her arms. If you don't mind me asking, what were you two doing here?
We were looking for Monica.
Why?
One of her friends came by the rectory, said that Mrs. Gallagher had taken her. He was very concerned.
About what?
We think Gallagher may have killed Eric.
Where can I reach you, Father? I might want to ask you some more questions later.
Actually, I'm not really sure. I'm kind of in between places right now.
Come and stay with me. At least for a few days. When do you think they'll take you back?
I'm not so sure I want to go back.
Of course you'll go back.
Not so sure, Maddie. It's not exactly what I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be helping people by spreading the word of God. Instead, I solicit money. I don't think I want to do that anymore.
What about St. Dominic's and the work you've been doing there? This Monica girl. I mean, isn't that what you set out to do?
They won't let me.
Since when do you need their permission to be a good priest? Bathroom's there. There's clean towels in the closet.
Maddie? I'm sorry.
You said that already.
Maddie?
Maddie. Maddie. Sorry.
Father Clements. Can I come for a little ride?
Do you have a lawyer here?
I don't know, Father. You need to have a lawyer here?
No, I don't think so.
Well, let's get started then. You might. Why did you go over to Ms. Gallagher's house last night?
I told you I was worried about Monica. I thought she might be there against her will.
Because she thought Mrs. Gallagher might have killed Eric Halloran?
I don't know. I think so.
How'd you get into the house?
The back door was open.
Yeah, that's what Father Andrew said the night we questioned him. You know a street kid named Cameron?
Yes, he's the one that told me about Monica.
Did you buy any heroin off him?
Of course not. That's ridiculous.
We found this in your room at St. Dominic's.
What is it?
That's a half a gram of high-quality smack.
It's not mine.
Somebody trying to frame you?
For what?
Mrs. Gallagher's death wasn't an accident. She got high, she nodded off, and someone injected her again. She got you kicked out of St. Dominic's, didn't she?
You think I killed her?
Maybe. Maybe somebody's just trying to make it look like you killed her. You've been looking into the Father Andrews murder, right?
Murder? Police said it was a suicide.
I'm a skeptic. Humor me. The question is, who wants you out of St. Dominic's for good?
Look, I don't have any more time for this. If you're going to charge me, charge me. If not, let me go.
We're good. Thank you for your time, Father.
We need to get to St. Dominic's.
Why? What happened?
The police think Mrs. Gallagher was murdered.
By who?
I'm not sure, but I think I know how to find out.
Threatened to tell my wife.
which would have been worse. So I went to see him. We fought. He fell. He betrayed me, Daniel, for money.
Why didn't you just come to me? Why did you go to Father Andrews?
Because I didn't need to chat. I needed to confess. He wasn't like you, Daniel. He believed. He really, truly believed. And then you started poking into things. I asked you to stop.
Henry, what do you need from me?
Absolution. Bless me, Father, for I have sinned. I have killed 3 people since my last confession.
Down.
They'll probably make Andrews a saint.
Put it down!
Henry!
Thank you.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.